Now let's continue this game. As soon as the rightmost invader touches the edge, it will tell everybody to turn around. So let's start a new script. For each invader, whenever it touching edge, it will broadcast. To tell everybody turn around and advance. And we also gave wait 2 seconds here, so it won't touching edge twice in a row. And receive turn around and advance, they will just turn 180 degrees, and move closer to the spaceship. Now you see they did turn around, but the problem is this first row, they were leading before the turn, but after the turn they are actually trailing behind. Take another look. That is because as soon as this invader touches the edge, the other rows immediately turn away. Instead of moving right, they move left. So after the turn, they are actually 2 steps ahead of the leading row. So to fix this, we need to do something for the leading row. Let's create a variable called the leading row for all sprites. And as soon as invader touches the edge, it will set leading row to its own row. And here, when I receive turn around and advance, every one of them will check if I am the leading row. If I am one of the invaders in the leading row, I need to make some adjustment. So if my row equals to leading row, I need to move ahead 2 steps. Each step is 8 pixels here, 8 pixels, and 2 steps, which is 16 pixels. Yeah. So now let's take a look. Yeah, it's get fixed. So this leading row is still leading. One more thing we can do here is make some marching sound. I found I cannot make every clone to make this sound, because there will be too many sounds. So I let the master to make the sound. So master will also wait for game mount to be won and wait for 0.2 seconds. That is the time for the first row to start to move. And we need to add some sound from the library. I found that those electric bass. Let's get C. D and E. So we will play like E, D, E, C. E. D. E. C. It sounds good. That's it. Thank you for watching. I will see you next time.